Hi, this is Manos Brilakis from the Minneapolis Heart Institute and the Cardiovascular Innovations Foundation, presenting case 75 for the Manual of Percutaneous Coronary Interventions. This is a case of a tortuous circumflex bifurcation. And this is the target lesion. This is a lesion of the first obtuse marginal and the mid-circumflex. It's a Medina 011, considering the proximal circumflex, the proximal main vessel, the mid-circumflex, the distal main vessel, and the OM1, the side branch. And the first thing that draws our attention here is the tortuosity, because the circumflex comes at an angle of about 120 to 150 degrees, so very hard to reach that part. The question here is, what is the best way to approach this? The side branch definitely needs to be preserved. It is a large obtuse marginal branch. How about the likelihood of side branch occlusion? That's kind of intermediate. There is some likelihood, but it is hard to tell for sure. And actually, for this case, we decided to do intravascular ultrasound. But our first concern was for getting guide wires down to the vessel. For a tortuous vessel like this, one might consider upfront use of a microcatheter. But nevertheless, we decided to first try with a workhorse guide wire. So this is an attempt with a Sion blue. The Sion blue enters the circ, takes some of the bend, but then the problem here is the prolapse. There is a prolapse of the wire into the LAD. And when we have a tortuosity, these are the four key ways for advancing guide wires. The first one is to use a different wire, for example, a polymer jacketed wire or a very soft wire like the SU03, and change the bend of the guide wire. The second is to use a microcatheter, and for tortuous vessels, using an angulated microcatheter like the Twin Pass and the Suzuki can be very useful. The third one is to use the reversed guide wire technique, in which a knuckle is created on the wire, which engages the vessel upon withdrawal. And the fourth one is to put a balloon in the main vessel and inflate it to deflect the wire and direct it into the side branch. We decided to try again with a workhorse wire, and these are repeat attempts with the same Sion blue. You can see the guide is backing out, showing that we're pushing relatively hard. But then eventually, the tip of the guide wire does make the bend and then creates this small loop. So we're past the lesion, but entering into a small vessel. And then we pull back a little bit. There is a little loop on the wire, and the loop does take nicely the bend. This is an example of knuckling with a workhorse wire, which can be used for tortuous vessels sometimes, and then advancing a little bit more, the wire nicely advances down to the distal circ. So here we were actually able to wire the circumflex without using a microcatheter or other advanced technique, just by using a workhorse wire. And then to our pleasant surprise, this is a second workhorse wire. We're trying to get into the first obtuse marginal branch. And similar to the circumflex, with some manipulation, we are able to advance the guide wire into the OM1. So what is the question? What is the next step now? And now that we have a little better visualization of the bifurcation, things look a little different. The lesion in the OM1 seems to be a little further from the ostium, and there is still the significant lesion in the main vessel just distal to the bifurcation. But here, provisional starts to make more sense. We can first treat the OM1 with a stent coming close to the ostium, and then use provisional by stenting into the circumflex. We did intravascular ultrasound, confirmed that there was soft plaque, and then delivered a stent in the first obtuse marginal branch, having a safety balloon into the circumflex. And having a large guide catheter, this is an 8-French femoral, does provide good support and helped with delivery. The problem here was that trying to deliver a stent now into the circumflex was fairly challenging. You can see we're pushing fairly hard. The stent is having a hard time taking the large bend, and the guide is being pushed back into the aorta. And it's always a balance about how much to push without pushing too much. Here we're pushing and withdrawing back, and then at some point we pushed a little too much, the guide prolapsed into the ventricle, and then we lost all the guide wires. And the lesson here is that it is always tough to know what is the fine balance. One wants to push relatively hard, but not too hard to lead to this loss of guide and guide wire position. Fortunately, we had already stented DOM1, so now we only have to get a wire down the circumflex. And this was accomplished once again using a Sion Blue workhorse guide wire. Same technique as above. The wire actually wants to enter into the DOM1. We pulled it back, redirected, and the wire did nicely close once again with a knuckle all the way to the distal circumflex. And this time, we were a little more careful, still pushing relatively hard, but not all the way so as to lose the guide catheter position. And this is the image after placement of the stent. The circumflex does look as if there is more disease, but this is likely the result of straightening this significant angulation. So we want to stent all the way from the proximal circumflex further down, jailing the origin of the first obtuse marginal branch. The stent was deployed, and there is a fairly nice result. However, there is a lesion distally, and the question is this a distal edge dissection, or is this spasm? And the best way to find out is to give intracoronary nitro, which we did, and actually the lesion appeared better. There was TIMI 3 flow. In summary, this case provides some useful lessons regarding treatment of highly tortuous lesions and bifurcations. The first one is that even in extreme tortuosity, using a workhorse wire may work. So you don't always need an angulated microcatheter or dual lumen microcatheter, but instead trying a workhorse wire first might be all that you need. The second is that better visualization and understanding of the bifurcation can help with deciding the treatment strategy. In this particular case, we thought it was a 0-1-1 bifurcation, and we were planning to do potentially a two-stent strategy. However, upon wiring and getting better images, it turned up being a 0-1-0 bifurcation, and was successfully treated with provisional stenting, jailing the obtuse marginal branch. Third, don't push too hard in cases where stent delivery is challenging. It's always important to avoid pushing too hard, as it may lead to losing wire position, which can be a catastrophic occurrence, because sometimes it may be very hard or impossible to rewire, especially when something like a dissection has occurred in the vessel during pretreatment. And finally, when there is a potential lesion in the edges of the stent after delivery, using nitroglycerin can help determine whether this is spasm that does not require any further treatment. Thank you.